This gaming videos. Joysticks and joypads.
Trackballs and mouse pads.
Spinners and light guns.
Fun.
Alien invasions.
Robotic invasions.
Dungeons and dragons.
Fun.
Home runs and touchdowns.
Jungles and ghost towns.
Videos from this sun.
Fun.
This is the Otronicon 2020 at the Orlando Science Center near downtown Orlando. The Science Center is five stories here of nature and science. It's the Orlando Science Center with nature thrown in. Five big stories. The Otronicon took all five of the stories. Tons and tons of technology stuff, VR, AR, robotics, video games, arcade stuff, medical devices, flight simulators, you name it, tons and tons of stuff. As we walk around one of the levels here, you can see companies like Microsoft in the background, there's Disney, there's also big companies like Lockheed Martin. Lots of big companies, lots of smaller companies, and there's lots of people. As I shot this video, it was actually early in the morning so that there were less people. This thing was packed most of the weekend. People come in from the whole Southeast to come see this. And as you walk around, you can not only all the stuff they bring in just for the weekend, but there's all the normal stuff at the Science Center that you can then go and play, and it's still all available. This year, the Orlando Science Center gave out awards for independent companies. I had nothing to do with these, so here we go. The O-Tronnie for 2020 for the best multiplayer game goes to, drumroll please, Whiffle Blasters from Suckerbird Games.
So Josh and I have been working together for a long time. We actually went to school together at Full Sail, and ever since we've just continually been working together. We started Suckerbird Games about 2 years ago, and we've been working on Whiffle Blasters ever since. It's in beta right now, so we're getting close to release, and from the beginning, Josh and I worked together in the games industry for about 4 or 5 years before starting up our own company. So it's a twin stick shooter. Basically the object of the game is to be the last man standing. You get one shot and then you have to slap each other and try and knock out the other opponents.
Now Orlando is one of the hotbeds in the United States for technology. AR, VR, video games, military applications, but also robotics. University of Central Florida is in Orlando. So right here you get to see the future of law enforcement. Murphy, right? You can also have little robots that can clean your carpet too, or you can control them from a little pad, which is actually fairly popular. A remote controller or a pad at the event, and you can move these robots. They don't have to all be like big-time robots. This one here shows the same thing. You have a little pad, a little controller, and you have these little lights that move from start to finish. Now, the edges were very low, so these things kept flying off the sides, which is kind of funny. But they had a second one over here where they could go a lot faster. The sides were a lot higher. So here, it just shows off that there are different applications for robots that you may not necessarily think of, like cars, making cars, military applications, and for games too, having a little bit of fun. Instead of having a video game in front of a computer screen, you have a physical game right here. Now Disney was here too. I mean, it's Orlando, it's Disney. Now Mickey, the Fantasia thing, if you take a look at him, you'll see water right next to him. Well, a little girl's waving her hand, and as she waves it, it moves the water up and down, which is kind of neat, so you can control the water like that. There were other little physical things to do. Here, you put some bricks inside a tree, and then, boom, stuff comes out. Physical stuff here as a kid. I'm going to try to do it, Dad. Let's see, move this. No, give it to me, son. Right? boom, and dad goes and does it for the son. But he did it. I don't know what they were doing. It was something there, physical. And here you have robots in the medical industry. So the woman here is moving the hands underneath the Da Vinci machine here. You'll see it go back and forth here. And what that does is moves the robots, and they're playing a game of here, which is, in real life would not be a game, right? This is how you can actually control robots. The doctors can do that. It's kind of cool. And so they got a little heart there. Let's put the heart back where it should be. And another one right here. It's kind of the same idea, but a very small, simple thing. So as she moved the things on the outside, you could see underneath is the robot doing things. Now the next O-Tronnie is going to be for Best Animated World. The Best Animated World for O-Tronnie 2020 goes to Magic Bytes for their gaming and computer lab.
Yeah, I started a company called Rainbow Arts initially. I co-founded in 1984. We started on Commodore 64, did some user programs like vocabulary learning, database, and we ventured into games, and we found out pretty quickly the games can say so much more, and eventually came to a split. And I founded Magic Bytes in 1987. So we like also Lego a lot, especially Lego Boost, Lego Powered Up, because you can connect it also to Scratch. Scratch comes as a plugin or extension for Lego, and you can, through our extension now, hook it up to Raspberry Pi, use your own sensors, use your own motors, and just make more out of Legos. I mean, you can animate a lot in Lego. And we found a store display from formerly Toys R Us, and we enhanced the whole display. So it has a lot of LEDs controlled by relays, and has a motor that controls the helicopter, and you can turn the whole display on and off. It can be anywhere in the building on the Wi-Fi network of Otronicon, and Scratch on a laptop also connect to the Magic Bytes gaming and computer lab and control it in Scratch. In the Central Florida area, which is a great spot to be now, is all the activity here in the technology sector. So we try really to become known in simulation, virtual reality, augmented reality, and education.
Now down on the first floor, there's a clubhouse down there, which is basically a room that they normally would eat in and things like that. But they had an arcade there. This year wasn't as many arcade games as last year, but they had competitions. And like I said earlier, less people here because I shot really early in the morning. And right now you've got a bunch of kids. They sign up online. They come and they play and they compete. And they have certain games, not only on the systems, but also on the arcade machines as well, which is actually kind of neat. E-gaming is becoming bigger and bigger and bigger. Actually, it's really big. Full Sail in Orlando has a whole gaming building now. It's like an arena. Here he's playing Donkey Kong, and this is a tough game. And so, Donkey Kong 3 was down there. One of the local arcades brought these in so that people could play them and take the classics from the 70s, 80s, and 90s and bring them to current day kids. None of these kids were born when any of these games actually came out. The arcade machines, none of them. Primal Rage, I used to work at Tilt Game Room at the mall. That was the early 90s. These kids were not around in the early 90s when we were messing with that. And apparently, Japanese games all have schoolgirls and bright colored fluorescent buttons to press. So the O-Tronnie for 2020 for the best flying game goes to Adventures of Flying Jack Grayson, PSI Games.
The Adventures of Flying Jack Grayson is a game that I personally commissioned from PSI Games. It's a side-scrolling, shoot-em-up sort of game. Flying Jack Grayson was developed by me, inspired by the era of exploration during the 1910s, 20s, and 30s. He's basically the embodiment of American heroism during World War I. going across the sea to fight the Kaiser in the name of liberty and freedom on behalf of the French Air Corps. As you can see, The Adventures of Flying Jack Grayson is in its early beta stages of playthrough. Right now, we're giving an example of how simple the gameplay mechanics are. It's no different than your average everyday arcade shoot-em-up. It goes up, down, left, right. You've got a fire button to shoot, as well as a button to drop bombs on enemies that are firing at you from below. It's going to be released to handheld devices such as Apple and Android very soon. My future plans for The Adventures of Flying Jack Grayson include that should this game prove successful and I'm able to accrue revenue from this game, much like every other game out there, I would like to create a sequel, and for the foreseeable future, I would like to produce other Flying Jack Grayson video games for handheld devices. Once The Adventures of Flying Jack Grayson is released, it is going to be free to play on all handheld devices. The only sort of monetization that is going to occur is there's going to be ads where if you die, you're going to have to watch an ad. So that should encourage you to be really good at the game.
There were a lot of physical things to do, particularly for the kids. Here's a Channel 9 WFTV in Orlando fake weather set where they can pretend that in the weather, right? Here they have a fan that you move showing how sand moves over millions of years, I guess. I've never been able to figure this one out. Here, there was some type of levitation with the balls, and so the kids would fight out the balls and try to make them levitate when they get them, and they never levitate for them. Here, I guess there's something like magnets or something, and you move it and the stuff inside the liquid moves in different shapes. As kids made paper airplanes, they would then crank it up and try to get it into this hole, which, by the way, no one ever does, so it's, you know. Here's a really cool thing. It spins, and then you have these ring thingies, and you throw it, and they're supposed to stay on for a very long period of time. Now, all of these are showing off physics and science. Here, kids get to make stuff, and they put it up there, and it comes down, and boom. Here's a, I guess it shows some type of kinetic kind of stuff. And, Mommy, no, 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 Mommy, no. I guess with pulleys and levers and stuff. No. So, whatever, you know what I'm saying. Here's a neat thing where you can build a car, help a mom, of course, here. And then what you do is after you piece it together, you go to this other area and you crank it up, you give it some kinetic energy, and right time, you press the right button and boom. And you see how far it can go. Here's another thing, but this shoots up. Wait, Dad, leave me alone. I got it. Boom! Right? So it's kind of fun stuff for the kids. Here, dude, you do not play with electricity. Mom even shook. No, Mom, don't. So Mom, oh, dude. No, you don't play with electricity. Bad. That's very bad. You take a look over the center area, you see balls going across. This is something they had at the Science Center normally, and it shows certain physics. Here, these kids had to actually assemble something with instructions, and it doesn't look like they're having an easy time with this, but you had different things, and they had to piece it together and put it into the correct rack. Now, the 2020 O-Tronny for best public resource goes to the Melrose Center, or the Dorothy Lumley Melrose Center for Technology, Innovation, and Creativity.
The Melrose Center, we are a co-working space. We give you access to workstations and computer workstations and all the equipment that you need to work on your creative projects, including a fully equipped video studio, audio studio, photography studio, fab lab, and game lab with simulators and workstations and everything. We're in the downtown library up on the second floor. We have a lot of events going on all the time, meetups that have to do with video production, audio production, photography, all digital media projects. And we give you access to all the tools to do that with, and all the knowledge as well we can share with you, teach you how to use everything. So every time we go to one of these events, like this one we're in today, we're at Otronicon, We make special content to display some of the equipment that we have available at the Melrose Center. For example, we have built in the past a virtual karaoke game where people can come in, put a virtual headset on, they're on a virtual stage, and they get to sing some of our most popular 90s and 80s songs while the audience just builds around them. We're also displaying a virtual boxing game where you get to choose your opponent. You can choose from a ninja to a zombie and beat up on, zombie apocalypse, pick up some, or a robot, or even a boxer, get the headset on, and you're right there in the middle of the ring beating them up. We have some other projects that we display, like, for example, to show off some of the video studio equipment. We have a digital escape room where you can come in, you get behind a green screen, and we put you into a monitor. And then you have somebody in the room trying to help you escape by pressing the keys on the keyboard. And then if you make it within a certain time, you escape the virtual room. Come check us out every time we go to one of these expos. We have all these equipment and pretty cool events going on. So
each of the levels and areas have their own thing at the Science Center. This area is Dino Digs. So during an event like the Otronicon, they still have the dinosaurs you can go in and see how big they are. Like, these are T-Rex right there in front of you. But they also have all this other stuff too that they bring in from all these companies to show off what they're doing. In front of you there is this Jurassic Ridge where parents can hang out and sleep, I guess, while the kids dig for fake dinosaur bones on the ground, which is kind of a fun thing for the kid. To the left right there, you can see the medical equipment where you can pretend to be a surgeon and get medical malpractice lawsuits against you. And then in this area over here is more military, Lockheed Martin, and other flight simulators. And in this room right here, this blue room, is the flight lab where you can go in and fly an airplane if you wanted to. Lockheed Martin had a bunch of simulators all around, because that's what they do. They're a big company, a lot of money. So as you walk around, you can see that there's tons and tons and tons of things to do at the Otronicon each year. Now, the 2020 O-Tronnie for Best Community Support goes to Indienomicon.
Indienomicon is a community that fosters culture and creativity around video games here in Central Florida. This year marks our 7-year anniversary coming this April. We are a meetup that meets once a month that brings in industry professionals as well as game demos and being able for those to participate at a free cost. We also do large social as well as productionable professional events that fosters from Melrose Center all the way to the Orlando Game Space. This year we're focusing on what we call the World Tour, so we're going to be going around to larger based venues and areas to really support and talk about what happens in our own backyard.
So it's not just the Orlando Science Center, but they have nature as well. Even though it's 5 stories, way up the top, they also have a telescope up there, so I don't know, 6 stories or so. If you take a look around, you'll see in the middle here, there are alligators, little baby ones, I don't know, they're like 3 feet or so, hanging out, laying around, looking for lunch. They have an area with some really ugly lizard guys that are really, really ugly. It's an area where they have different animals and fish, an aquarium where kids could see and learn about nature, because nature is really kind of like science, but not really. It is, but it isn't. And over here you have a really ugly fish. Man, there's some ugly fish. This is like the ugly fish area. And so kids could learn about the world as well. This here is, it's in Florida, so there's sinkholes in Florida. This shows you what a sinkhole looks like from the road. It goes underground, and you can see what makes it in 3D in real life, which is actually kind of cool. The Florida aquifer, which has a bunch of water where you drink underneath the surface, just shows you kind of like what it looks like in real life. We have lots of sea turtles, and it shows you how sea turtles, they lay their eggs. So you have to learn all this stuff as well. they have areas where they have physical stuff like artwork. This is a physical 3D artwork thing they have out near the cafeteria, the subway in there where you can eat. And this is one of the things you can look at. And of course, as we saw earlier, the T-Rex. And if you stand there and look underneath them, you realize these guys are big, man. They crunch on you big time. This is the elastic platypus or something. Elastomophorus, I don't know, some dead animal. And of course, we talked about the Jurassic Ridge, where you can go in there with the kids and dig up fake dinosaur bones if you wanted to. Now the 2020 O-Tronnie for Best School Program goes to Level Up Academy.
At Level Up Academy, we teach game development and game design to kids in middle school and high school. The great opportunity that we have is that we operate out of the Orlando Game Space in downtown Orlando, which is a co-working office focused around emerging tech and games. So, the reason that separates us is because the kids get an opportunity to see firsthand professionals actually at work, and they get an opportunity to shadow those professionals and to have them as their teachers and to be exposed to that type of work early on. We use games, we use all sorts of different technology to teach these types of principles to kids to help them get a head start on their careers in technology or in gaming. The gaming industry is good for kids to get into because all different tech industries take from gaming. Everything from healthcare to aerospace and everything under the sun takes from the gaming industry because game developers have learned early on how to solve complex problems. So getting your kid involved in game design and game development could be very good for just a career in technology in general, but especially if they are interested in video games.
So this section is the Our Planet. I want to say Our Gang. It's the Our Planet. This is the fifth level that's normally here. So this is stuff with planet, where you had like a dinosaur area. Well, this is more planet kind of stuff, Earth. And there are a lot of indie companies here, not just video games, but other companies here. So you can walk around and you can do the normal stuff that you normally do, and you get to see places where you can go to school and teach the kids how to code. There are independent video game companies, and they actually show you the code. They'll sit there and they'll program or do artwork in front of you, and you can watch how games are actually being created. There's areas for education. There's a globe over in the back over there to the left, which shows you the world and how you relate to the world. And there's a lab over here where you can go in and they can have like experiments, like a Mr. Wizard kind of thing where you can learn stuff. And there's all these things that are going on. So it's kind of really cool to being able to go to an event and still do this stuff. So it's not that people didn't just go there for the indie stuff or the show, they also went there for the regular stuff. So the whole family goes to these things, and it's a good fun weekend that everybody enjoys doing. Now the 2020 O-Tronnie for the best casual game goes to Oink by Rumrunner Entertainment.
Oink is a fun and a cute 3D platformer. It was created in the love of Crash, Spyro, Super Mario 64, and the classic 3D platformers of the 90s. This is made very much in the love of that, and the intent obviously is to bring it back because I feel like there's a huge void in the market in terms of 3D platformers. So Oink is a fun and a cute 3D platformer. The primary characters are going to be Max, who is a pig, and then it's going to be Tedwin, which is a small robot bear. And the entire objective of the game is to essentially find the leader of their tribe. They have gone to foreign islands, and you have to explore each of the islands to try to uncover the mystery of where he went and how to find him. And the mechanics are similar to pretty much any other 3D platformer that you've ever played. It's made in the love of that, so if there's a mechanic of that, you can almost bet it's going to be in there, from swinging to climbing to button smashing. It's there. So the build that you see here is only about 25% done, like completed with the entire game. The objective, of course, is to continue to develop the game independently and to put it on both Steam and the Microsoft Independent Developers page.
The Flight Lab is an area at the Orlando Science Center where it's a two-person experience. One person has a VR on over the face, flying an airplane. The other person is the air traffic controller telling the other person what to do. So it's a two-person experience. It's actually kind of fun to do this thing right here. Dr. Dare's lab, or Dr. Dre's lab, depending on where you're from, is an experiment thing. So you go there and have all these experiments where you can mess around and have fun and learn things. Discovery Stage is an area where they have presentations, where you have presenters come up and they give lectures and they talk about stuff, whatever topic, with a bunch of people watching. And downstairs they have areas where you can buy stuff, plus you can build things for free, or if you build things you can pay a couple of bucks and get it. So here the kids are putting in little designs and making stuff. I guess that's fun, right? And here was an area where mom could take pictures of the kids. Now this is the 80s, Rubik's Cubes and things like that. Giant Rubik's Cubes, I don't remember those. And they can take pictures and have fun. And over one of the corners they had like a Space Invaders display, a little art kind of area there, kind of a 3D thing. And of course, there's the store. Every place you go to, whether it's Disney or Universal or whatever, there's always a store somewhere trying to sell their stuff. So there's a bunch of art, nature, science thing if you wanted to buy that kind of stuff. The 2020 O-Tronnie for Best Education Experience goes to Intellivance.
In 2011, my co-founder and I got together. He had a big background in technology and I had a background in music and psychology. He had been working on a system where we could use music and art to help improve cognition and things like math and science skills, while unbeknownst, I was working with my company on a system that would have the ability to apply the math side of music theory and application to help with behavioralism and emotions. The first technology we actually have on display here is something we call a touch board, and the purpose of the touch board was to be able to give access to applied music theory to any individual of any age or ability level, because the problem we would fall into, you have to have years of training on a standard instrument to be able to start getting into the creative aspects. So we needed something to really help us level the playing field that anyone could dive into and start making music. This way they could begin improving cognition and emotion states as soon as possible. The second display we have here is showcasing some of our tactile manipulatives. Early on, we kind of emphasized more technology and more electronics, but we started to realize as time went by, we really needed to have products that would be available to everybody regardless of cost points. So we decided to start getting into things such as blocks, cards, mats, because fundamentally everything about Intellivance is about building logic steps, sequences, and pathways to brain improvement. So those are examples of things that you could use without technology. We like to think of it as no tech, low tech. But also, in the future, we hope that all of these manipulatives will also be able to integrate with other technologies and software substances. The third thing we brought out to display today is something we call Prime Space. It's our first video game we've ever made, and I'm very, very proud of it because it was a complete team effort. It was the first thing we ever designed that every single employee at the company worked on together to accomplish. And fundamentally what the game does, it's very similar to a space shooter like Galaga or Space Invaders, but the object is that you actually have to shoot the color blocks, which represent composite or prime numbers. So while kids are actually sitting there shooting and getting high scores, you're actually absorbing multiple sensory impressions based on prime number theory, which of course is kind of the bedrock of pre-algebra and all of your high school math. After the Otronicon show, in the next two quarters, we're actually planning to launch our first product catalog, and we hope to get into markets such as education, occupational therapy for seniors, early juvenile intervention for at-risk socioeconomic youths, and even things such as intellectual and developmental disabilities, children with autism. We really, really believe that we're sitting on an intellectual property and a system that can level the playing field for all learners of all ability levels and all ages.
Now Microsoft was there, big company, a lot of big companies here too. They were showing off their Surface, tablets, video games, that kind of stuff. This is an oversized coloring pad, right? Coloring book. Now, instead of spending like 99 cents for a coloring book, you got to spend a little more money on that. But it's a lot more fun when you have a big tablet where you can move things around with your fingers and so forth. And over on the side here, had a group of kids that were playing games on Microsoft products, obviously. There were other areas. Here's a racing game that kids were playing. And the whole place had things like this spread out all around to do like this. I don't know what these guys are playing, some educational stuff, but lots and lots and lots of this kind of stuff everywhere. And sometimes you get a mom to help out, sometimes not, sometimes you figure it out. Here is a silicon wafer. It's in a microscope, and I put the camera up to it, and it shows you how it actually looks close up. That's kind of cool. They had an area, this one's called the Hive. You go over there and kids can learn. They have classes they teach normally and during this, so you can learn stuff in groups. It's kind of cool. So the O-Tronnie for 2020 for best platformer game goes to Jungles of Maxtheria by SlifkerGames. This is a 2D side-scrolling platformer game where you go through the jungles as either a male or female, adult or child. So there's four different characters. You go through the jungles, you collect treasure, you go through locked doors, you go find keys, there's treasure chests, there's bad guys, you go above ground, below ground. It's a side-scrolling jungle adventure kind of thing. It's actually pretty kind of neat. This is Jungles of Maxtheria. So the O-Tronnie for 2020 for best digital co-working goes to the Orlando Game Space. Now the Orlando Game Space is an area near downtown Orlando where a bunch of video game companies rent out space, and they're all like together in this building. And as you can see, different companies, they can either do one table, they could do one computer, they can bring their own equipment, they can rent equipment, they can do offices. So it's this whole building, that kind of stuff. Out back, they've got this artwork that looks like graffiti, but actually if you look at the camera, you can see that it's augmented reality. See the guy moving around back there? The O-Tronnie for best ticketing platform for 2020 goes to ViewStub. ViewStub is a ticketing platform. It's not like a traditional one. It's if, let's say you have an event like a concert and it's sold out and you want to sell more, well, you can broadcast that on the internet and sell the internet television broadcast as well, and people would pay for that. So as a presenter, you can use it for whatever content you have, or also you can go there as a customer, as a viewer, and pay to watch whatever you want there. The O-Tronnie 2020 for the best serious game goes to Dragonfly Titan by Dragonfly CG Artwork. What this is a simulation, which I have stills. It's actually a 3D simulation of a craft that will be leaving in a few years, and they've done a simulation of what it's supposed to look like and what it's supposed to do. It's actually kind of cool. The 2020 O-Tronnie for best game simulation goes to Parker's Grocery. Now, I didn't really get to be able to shoot this particular one, but I have a still here. It's a 3D isometric game where it's kind of like SimCity, but with a grocery store. Now this globe is the coolest thing at the Science Center. It's a giant white ball, but there's four projections and a project on it, and in real time you can see stuff that's happening across the globe. You can even go back decades and see the effects of climate control and global warming globally. UCF was there and other colleges, and a lot of companies were showing off technology for kids that maybe want to get into video games, but here they're doing a lot of VR kind of stuff. And if you've never done VR, you put a headset on, the tracker, and then you have controls on your hands, and you move the controls around, and that's a way of walking. So instead of physically walking, which you can't because you have cables attached to, you can use it with the controllers. The controllers could be weapons, like if you have a Dungeons & Dragons type game, or it could be a gun, or whatever. But it's actually really cool to do the VR stuff. Here, it's VR, but it's in a green screen, so the green gets replaced by a flight simulator. This is Lockheed Martin, and the chair moves. It's just like being in a real airplane. This is like super cool. Another area downstairs, they had an automobile where on the top, there's a projector which projects onto a giant screen a course for you to drive on. And the car actually moves as you move left and right, and it bumps, just kind of like a real racing simulator. This here was an art area where this lady designed music to go along with, I guess these are fluorescent light bulbs, and as they played, the light bulbs would play. It was actually kind of a neat, suedo kind of artsy-fartsy thing. Here's another racing simulator where I guess anybody these days can get a license to have a car. As long as you don't run into a wall or something, you'd be good. Here's the coolest thing ever. This is a racing simulator with VR on it. And as you can see in the background, what he actually sees, so you put it on there and it moves you left and right. And for me, since I get motion sickness, this is a puking machine for me, but it's still really, 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 really cool. And this one here, you control the aircraft that's going through this tunnel of spacecraft. And if you look down, you'll see a little paddle thing. So you move it left and right, and it's kind of a fun little thing for the kids. So you jump on it and you have to control it, versus using a joystick, you use the thing on the floor, which is actually kind of a neat thing to do.
So, funny story about Biff. Obviously, long before I was a CEO of a tech startup, my background was in music performance, and I was in a jazz fusion band, which is instrumental jamming type stuff, and we had our first and only gig ever in DeLand at a little place called Happy Days. And we got there before the gig about 2 hours, and we realized we didn't even have a band name yet, and so the venue's like, well, what are we going to introduce you as? And for some reason, all day, we were joking about the character Biff from Back to the Future, and so at an impulse we said Biff for a day, and literally that was the only day, the one gig we ever played, and that was the first thing that I thought of when I saw the Biff's gaming videos. I said I once was Biff for a day as well.
It's awesome. So that was the Otronicon 2020, the Orlando Electronic Interactive Convention. They have it every year in Orlando in January. Maybe after seeing this, if you're in a different city, you can try to get your local science center, your local convention area, to do something like this with technology. That would be really cool for you, your family, and the whole community. It's really cool.